Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to give you 5 easy things that you can do to improve a design you're working on. All right, let's get started. The first thing you can do to improve a design is to modify the headline text. Don't just type it out in whatever font and call it good. And here are a few ways that you can do that. Instead of just typing out your headline like this, you can do something like this and use 2 different fonts. I really like pairing a sans serif with a script, and this just adds interest. Another thing to try is to modify the first letter. I'm here in Illustrator, and in this example, I'm just going to enlarge this P. So I'll hit Shift T to get to my touch type, which is right over here in the toolbar, and then I'll click the P. And now I can just make this a little larger. I can rotate it a little bit, move it down, and then I'll click that A and move it a little bit underneath. And honestly, it's not a huge difference, but I think this type of text modification does improve a design. Another way to modify a headline is to use different sizes of words like we did here in this first example. I've got a really small escape to and then a much larger paradise. And this helps to establish hierarchy and which words are important. If you struggle with trying to figure out what is the more important words, just say them out loud and try to notice which one you put more emphasis on. So if we just say, escape to paradise, paradise sounds like the most important word in the sentence. Now, this part down here isn't the headline, obviously, but you can also use color and make parts of your text bold to also drive that emphasis home, like I did here with all-inclusive. If you're looking for more playful text, a good idea is to bounce the letters up and down. So I'm going to hold Option and drag this to make a copy, and I'll get back on that touch type tool. And now I'll just click on each letter and bounce it a little bit up and down. You can also rotate some letters and move them around. Maybe we'll move this one a little bit up more that way. So this just looks a little more interesting, and that's what we're shooting for. Another way to improve a design is to just make sure that text is readable on whatever background you happen to put it on. If you're putting light green text on a red background, that probably isn't the best idea, for example. If you're putting text over a photo, just try to find a spot in the photo that's not so busy. So this is really busy right here, and it makes paradise hard to read. So in this case, I'll just put this here, and we'll put this down here. You can move your photo too, as long as you have space over here. Now in Photoshop Beta, they have something called generative fill. And if your image isn't long enough, you can use that to extend your photo. And I actually have another video about that, and it'll be right up in the upper right corner of your screen if you want to take a look. Currently, it's not available for commercial purposes though, so keep that in mind. And here's another thing to think about. Anytime you have something like this little boat in the background, also, this is a princess ship, not a starboard ship. You want to remove anything that's distracting like that. Obviously, you would get a starboard cruise ship here. I got these from pexels.com, so they're just random images. But I want to show you how to edit this image in Photoshop to just remove those really easily. I'll click on the image, and then I'll go to my links. Here's the image. I'm going to right-click and choose Edit with Adobe Photoshop. Now I'll zoom into this little area right here. With my rectangle marquee, I'll just select it. And then we'll do Edit, Content Aware Fill. And usually this will just erase it, which is great. And so this is what it looks like. We'll go ahead and say OK. So now that little boat is gone. And we'll do the same for Princess Cruises here, except this time I'm going to use my polygonal lasso tool. You might have to click here and hold down to get to that tool. And I'll just draw a box around Princess Cruises. And we'll do Edit Content Aware Fill again. And here's our result. It's okay. Probably for our purposes, it'll be fine, but we can also erase the things that we don't want to see in that part. And then I should have just left this little piece right here because that's so close to it. We really should include that. And now our result is looking a little better. So we'll say okay. And then hit Command D or Control D to get back out of that. And even though this is probably coming from that little boat we erased, that doesn't bother me, I'm okay with it. So we'll go ahead and save with Command S or Control S. I was in InDesign, so I'm going back to InDesign. It will automatically update there. Another way to make sure your text is readable is to change it from white to dark or vice versa. So if we have the word escape right here, I don't think that is readable enough. So in that case, I would just change it to this purple down here. You'll want to select it, get your eyedropper tool, and just click it. So now this is much more readable on this background. Now if your whole photo is busy, it might make sense to add an overlay in Photoshop to make it a little darker or a little lighter. And to do this, we'll come back over here to Photoshop. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. I'm gonna create a new layer. I'm gonna get on my gradient tool and just draw a gradient across it. And I like to do multiply. Now this, generally speaking, will give you a pretty dramatic result, but you can always knock the opacity down right over here in your layers panel. And by the way, if you're not seeing these panels over here, they'll all be under window. So I'm gonna put this at, let's say, 57, maybe 50%. And then I'm going to brighten up this side by getting on my dodge tool. I'm gonna make a really big brush and I'll come up here and change it to 0% hardness. And then we can start just painting over this part of the gradient of the parts that we want to keep light. Okay, and this looks good. Now this is a JPEG, but you can also save as a PSD file if you want to keep your layers. And that's really what you should do. But just for this example, I'm going to flatten the image and then save. Then we'll come back in here to InDesign. We'll go to our links panel. I'm going to click these three little lines and then we're just going to update all links. And now you can see how much this white text pops on the darkened background. Having a gradient overlay on your photo can be tricky. If it's a really light photo, you'll probably want to lean towards more of a white overlay instead of something like this, which is actually a darker overlay. And of course, you want it to look natural. So keep that in mind when you're working with this. The third tip is to align things. Alignment really helps readability and it lowers the chaos factor when someone looks at your design. You don't want them to look at it and go, oh my gosh, you know, I can't even tell what I'm supposed to look at here. Let's look at a few examples on canva.com. Canva is pretty great for inspiration. You can get a Canva account for free so that you can see all their design templates. Once you're logged in, you want to come to templates right here. I'm just going to scroll down a little bit and choose Docs. These will have a lot of different examples of alignment. So I'm going to click on this first one. You can see here that all of these boxes are aligned on the left side. And then all the bullet points are also aligned, although they're indented a little bit. Let's look at another one. I'll click on this Brand Designer Starter Kit. And now I'm going to check out this resume. This resume looks really nice because so much of it is aligned nicely. It's just very readable. So all these things are aligned here, and then these icons are also aligned with each other. You'll notice that these two are not aligned, and that's okay because these are all aligned vertically along an axis here, and these are all aligned right here. So you might find that it bothers you because, you know, this is not aligned with this, but as long as you have some sort of alignment going in your design, it'll help immensely. The fourth tip is to overlap things. So if two things are like almost touching, but not quite, or actually touching, that can be intentional sometimes, but a lot of times it's something the designer overlooked and it causes your eyes to kind of focus in on that point. So what you wanna do is either overlap it or move those two objects farther apart. Here's an example of what I mean with text just barely touching something right here. This really bothers me because it just draws your eye and it just does not look like it should be that way. It looks like a mistake. So to fix this, I would just move this over, maybe move this down. Maybe we could put this here. We're also running into the other problem, which is it's not showing up very well in this background. So I'm going to highlight that. I'll get on my eyedropper tool and just change this to another color in the project. And I think this works much better. This also is not showing up very well against its background. So in that case, I just make it white. And then the last tip is to leave some sort of margin for text. So you don't want to get too close to the edge of your design with text, unless, you know, it's really huge text or, you know, running off the edge on purpose. Here are a couple examples where I used a margin to keep the text away from the edge of the actual project, which is right here. So when I'm designing these things, I actually add my own little margin. I'm going to change this to a dotted line so it'll be a little more obvious. And then I don't let anything go outside this margin if it's text. Now, of course, there are exceptions, but if it's getting too close, I would just reduce my text size instead of stepping outside that margin. It just doesn't look that good if you have something right up next to the edge. I'm going to undo to get back to where we were. Now, here's another example of not being able to read something because of something in the background. So in this case, I would go ahead and click on the background, go to my links, right-click this, and just edit with Photoshop. Okay, so to fix this, I'm going to hit J to get to my spot healing brush. I'll make it a little bigger. And on a Mac, you can hold Control Option and just drag to the right to make your brush bigger. I'm not sure where the keyboard shortcut is on a PC. So I'll just go over this area with the spot healing brush and it just gets rid of it completely. We'll save this and then go back to our document. And now it's so much more readable. Now this invisible margin also is a good thing to follow when you're designing a button. So I also have an invisible margin here and I don't want my button text to get too close to that edge. This is way too close in my opinion. So I definitely want to get more space between right here and right here. And this is something I see all the time on buttons, the text coming too close to the edge of the button. And I think it's such an easy fix. It's just something to look out for. Now I might do more videos like this on this topic. If you have any ideas of little simple things you can do to improve your designs, please leave those in the comment section below. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.